Is my mic hot? Mic is hot. Okay. I don't have YouTube music though. I gotta get some YouTube music. Gotta get some cool jams on for the night. I thought about, what was I thinking? I was thinking about putting on some like Beethoven or something. Something just chill. But hello, my name is Dinah B2B. What is up, everyone? I am your friendly internet. Wait, what is my introduction? I'm your friendly internet mocap AI. And I do mocap. And I want to teach people about mocap. That being said, I haven't really talked about mocap because I'm not really sure what to talk about sometimes. I know there was some stuff coming out about Baldur's Gate. I don't know how much I can really contribute to the conversation other than good job. Did good job. Yeah, alright, let's yoink this down so I don't blast anybody's ears out. Or mine, more importantly. Okay. Yoink. I don't think that's coming through. No, it should. Right. It's just. Do I? Oh, that's why. Doop a doop a doop a doop a doop a doop. Alright, I'm gonna do something really stupid. I'm gonna yoink it all the way up. Hold on, let me turn it down. I'm gonna yoink it all the way up on YouTube and then slowly turn it up in OBS and hopefully it doesn't blow anyone's ears out because my audio is all the way down on my headphones. I refuse to have good audio balancing. Just. Are you sure this isn't like muted or something? Okay. Well, I'm gonna just with the full force and willpower assume my audio is okay. Also, I am currently entertaining my cat because she kept crying at me before the stream, and I finally figured out I think she just wanted attention and to play. And I think I got a cat hair in my mouth. Ew. Blech. 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 I'm not positive I got that out of my mouth. Blech. yeah, so as the title says, I suppose a little context here for people who aren't in the Discord. I was thinking about it and I'm like, you know, I don't think it's public right now, but I thoroughly enjoyed doing a tier list for transits I've been on. And I was like, well, gosh darn it, I enjoy shitpost tier lists. So I was like, well, obviously I can't just do any kind of tier list. Like, you know, everybody's already done all tier lists. But, you know, the whole transit was very specific to my community because we're passionate about transit. And by passionate, I mean angry. I have pure rage for transit authorities in America specifically. Hello, German Taker Johnny. How you doing on this fine evening? I hope the audio isn't too loud for you because it's not doing anything on my end. As far as I know, it's not playing. I guess I could look at the volume mixer. It says it's coming through. Audio is fine. Horrible. Oh man, I'm so sorry. TBH, horrible me. Me is horrible, I understand. I'm sorry, my friend. I hope chilling out here on this little casual stream is helps brighten your evening. I was like, I like Pokemans, but people have already tier listed Pokemans. So what's very unique to me is that I really like going on the Pokemon Center and just looking at their new products. They came out with their Christmas stuff. This is in no way an advertisement for Pokemon Center. Don't look at my hideous, but like, they have holiday Pokemon stuff now. And I was really tempted to get this Wooloo sweater, but I really like Pokemon Center. There's quality products there. So I was like, let's raid all their plushes they got for their starters. Little did I know this is going to be at least a two-parter series, because there's like 9 regions, and some of these have a lot of plushes and some of them have very little plushes. So like, it's kind of bad. You can clearly see which ones are, starters are more loved than others. This isn't a, we love you. This is the meme of, I love you equally, but I love you more.
Hops. No going upstairs.
The cat is on the stairs and she is slowly walking up. After I told her, she's not allowed going up the stairs.
Hops, come on.
All right, it's fine. She's being a little shit. It's fine. I think I missed it toward the end, but Fruitsy Collins gave Noodle. I think they gave Noodle Cat. I think they gave Noodle Cat a sub or a subscription to my channel. So thank you, Fruitsy. And then the reddest rabbit followed me. So thank you. Thank you for joining us in this chaoticness. Let's get down to this. So I very quickly discovered a few things. One is that there's like a huge leaning towards the original, I think this is Kanto, the original Kanto Pokemans. So we got here our blue boy Squirtle, we got our green boy Bulbasaur, and we got Charmander, the little fiery lizard boy. And I feel like it's pretty even, you know, pretty even. They all have generally the same out. So also my, there is like, they have keychains and like sometimes like they'll have hats or like bat cacks. I basically base this on, can I hold this if I'm having an emotional moment? And technically you could hold a hat or a backpack. That was basically my criteria of if I counted this as a plush or not to be graded. So like, I'm also, I don't know, everything else is fairly arbitrary. So like, if we, let's zoom in a tad here, shall we? No, that's gonna mess up my framing. We're gonna mess up my framing here. Yeah, let's just get started with Squirtle Boy. It was like, I was surprised. Okay, so I will say a lot of these actually are out of stock because Pokemon Center has a habit of having an item, selling out of it, and then leaving the listing up, but you can't, it'll never be filled. So that's a big sad. But yeah, so I feel like I should pull up OG Squirtle. Here, let me pull up OG Squirtle from like the anime. We're gonna go with the anime. And this is just to get an idea of how like the one-to-one comparison is of this boy. So as you can see, he's got this like blue boy body going on. His eyes are kind of like this reddish brown. he got a turtle shell going, and it's kind of like this cream and like a brown, right? So first off, I think all of these fail because none of this is the right color of his eyes. Like, this is not the same color. I think this one is, his eyes are red and demonic. He kind of has a huggable body, I presume. He's B tier. He's B tier. He's probably, I can't remember the sizes of some of these, but I just remember some of them have, like, it's the same plush in different sizes, and I think that's really funny, but this isn't one of them. This boy, he's flat. He is turtle. His eyes, he's kind of oblong, not very rounded. This guy has a round head, but, like, I think this is one is, like, the squishy, like, sleeper boys, like, the happy cuddler. I don't remember what it's called, but I think his color's more accurate. The eyes feel less demonic because it's the red to black ratio is not bad. It's not bad. Whereas this boy, he has big red eyes. It's not very great. Not very great. So yeah, he's I think he's A tier. I think he's great for cuddles. Great for cuddles. This boy is a backpack. I think the idea is great. The execution is poor. No other comments. D tier. I will say, if you never saw the original Kanto Pokemon, that's like the first Pokemon anime, Squirtle. Squirtle's great. He came from the Squirtle Squad. Squirtle has nothing wrong with him. He's not as cute as some of the other starters. So I'm a little biased when I say I don't particularly like him, but I do like to cuddle things. My friend is currently at Disneyland, and she sent me a picture of their like Loth cats because I think they have like new merchandise in the Star Wars land because of Ahsoka, and like he's a big boy, he is the biggest boy. I don't know how else to explain it. He's just the biggest boy. Like apparently it's like it's gonna like if it's like. My keyboard, which is like, I think it's like an 80% keyboard. Apparently it's bigger than that. And his head's so big and he's sleepy. I forgot where I was going with this, but I kind of want it. He's plush. He's plush. We were talking about Pokemon plushes though. This boy is a hat. I think out of all three of these though, I'm going to be honest. I think Squirtle is the best hat. I would never buy any of these. I already do dumb, silly looking stuff. I can't be seen with a Squirtle on my head. That being said, I think it's the best. This is gonna be B tier. Also the eyes are too red. I really think they need to invest in some different embroidery colors for Squirtle eyes. This boy, he big chonky. For some reason reminds me of a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. I don't like how weirdly, like, humanoid it is, even though I think that's fairly accurate. But, like, it doesn't have the cute factor of the original Squirtle. A D tier. He's not cute. He's not cute. I think the color's pretty accurate, but he ain't cute. He ain't cute. This boy, he's stupid. He looks stupid. He is plush. I would 10 out of 10 would throw this at somebody's head. A tier. The color is off, but that's okay. I can throw it at people. He is round. That is all you need to know. This boy, he has scarf. Scarf is good. That's about all. I think this is actually supposed to be for Mystery Dungeon. If you look up the Mystery Dungeon games, if you haven't seen them before, they wear, like, little scarves. It's so cute. And I had Mystery Dungeon, and then I just straight up stopped playing it at, like, the second mission. I don't know. I'm not very good at these games. I just want to collect cute Pokemon. But he is Scarf. He is, he's a... Okay, you know what? No. 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 There we go. The world has been righted. This is fine. This boy. So actually, you, I don't know if you can really see it on stream, but you can notice this is like, he's kind of shiny. I kind of went down this weird rabbit hole, but apparently at some point, Pokemon Center had these like Squirtle, Bulbasaur, and Charmander plushes that were made out of like kimono fabric, I think. So they're not very color accurate, but I think I've felt this kind of fabric before, and it's very cute. He's definitely more turtle than he is Squirtle. He sits like a good boy. He has little flappers and feeps like a child or like a Cabbage Patch doll. I had a Cabbage Patch doll, and I'm going to be honest, I did not like it. I really hated dolls as a kid. I really preferred like animals. Like I had this plush raccoon that I named Trashy. And I had a plush squirrel named Nutty. You can tell I didn't really have any original names. Original names was not mine. I think the most original named thing, plush I had was, I had a panda plush named Emma. Because I actually decided to look at a baby book to name my panda. But then everything else kind of got normal names. Like I had a Siberian tiger. Her name was Stripey because she had stripes. Let's see, what are some of my other favorites? Oh, I had a Webkinz dog named Sweetie. So I guess that's semi-original. Yeah, but the short of it is naming not child Dinah's forte. This boy, he's good boy. You know what? No, I think he deserves a S tier. I would, if they bought this back, I would buy him. He's a good boy. He sits well. This boy, I don't know. Kind of just exists. Hello, Daya. Hello, Starman. How are you doing tonight? We already got the whole tier list started with the plushes. I think I have cat hair in my mouth. That's not washing out. This is probably a good time to mention that I'm allergic to cat saliva. Sleepy Bulbasaur wins, GG. I don't know. No, he's actually quite a big good boy. I might actually pull up some of the listings because they're pretty great. But this boy, he exists. He's E tier. E tier for he exists. I have no comments about him. He's not cute. He stands. No. Let's move on to good boy Bulbasaur. Oh look, the cat decided to follow the rules. And cry. This boy, he sits good. I think it's a small boy, but I definitely feel the urge. If this is like palm size, I have the strong urge to throw this at someone's face. And I hope it has like the little beans at its feet so then it hurts more. He is S tier for, Dinah's definitely getting kicked out by security. we got this boy. Oh, this good boy is great. Look at him. Look at this boy. He flops. His bulb is very bulby. He's little feeps. He has a cute little smile. We're gonna ignore the fact. I don't think. Hold on. Bulbasaur. I don't think this is color accurate. I'm gonna be honest. I don't think any of these are particularly color accurate. But like, look at this boy. Look at this boy. Color accuracy, zero. That doesn't mean that he's not a good-looking boy. Would protect, would put on my, like, car dash if small enough. Definitely, just for because it's not color accurate, we're going to put him in A tier. He's not as cute as this boy. Actually, no, he's cuter, but it, color accuracy. Right. Backpack. Backpack Bulbasaur, gonna be honest, it's not the cutest thing in the world. Frankly, if I turned to like my turn to look at somebody and I saw this face staring at me, I would be terrified. Oh, someone has a lot of complaints. Sorry, I think I need to keep my cat entertained as I'm doing this. I think she has a lot of complaints to the management about not playing with her for the past couple of weeks. Either that or she wants something else. I can't tell. I promise I fed my cat. She just wants to play. She has a lot of energy. And has a lot to say. Someday she'll come on mic and share her thoughts with us. But for now, she's lying on the floor, distracting me. But yes, this boy, much like the other Bulbasaur, or the other Squirtle backpack, is D4, that was an idea. That was an idea. Also, this hat, I will say, kind of has, I don't hate it. I do not hate it. I kind of wish it was just the bulb, so you could pretend you're a Bulbasaur, which would look equally ridiculous, if not more ridiculous. I don't have an R tier for ridiculous, so we're going to put this in C tier for didn't see that coming from Pokemon. Yeah. Sleepy Bulbasaur will be saved for last. Let's be real. This boy's kind of derpy. I also question their stitching. Like, he's got a little mask going on here. A little stitching. Like, what gives, Pokemon Center? I thought we had better making of plushes and stuff. What gives? I want. And then like his horn ears look more like horns. So he's like a green weird devil thing. Not cute. The more I look at this thing, the more I'm like, but why? Why did you make this? I can't put it in B tier. This is, I'm sorry, he's too derpy. He goes into E tier for existence is questionable. by the way, I only got through, I think, 4 or 5 regions because I realized that I would have way too many pages. So we're going to have to split this up because once we get to Sinnoh, you know who was the favorite. This boy, he wears scarf. He is very round. His stitching makes it look like he's not sure what he's doing. Unsure. He's B tier along with his other buddy. There we go. This boy. This one is also the series that was made out of kimono fabric. Very cute. His face is very round. Hilariously so, in fact. Patterning on his bulb. Very cute. The eyes. Slightly demonic. If this was a real life creature, that head, yes, it's a moon face. Real life creature, the head to body ratio is absolutely fucked. This is an abomination of nature. He is very cute though, so he's gonna go in C tier for cute. He's a little too derpy for anything higher. There's a certain amount of derp that you need to be cute. And it's a delicate balance, and he's not hitting the delicate balance. Lastly, we got Good Sleepy Boy. I'm pretty sure Good Sleepy Boy is absolutely enormous. Let me just triple check that real quick. Wait, okay, hold on. I'm doing terrible. Give me my Pokemon Center back, and we're gonna look up Bulbasaur plushes real quick. I think I go to the Pokemon Center like far more than everybody else. I like to think that I bring them more traffic than anyone else. I want just Bulbasaur plushes. I don't care about anything else. Give me Bulbasaur plush. Oh, he is a big boy. I'm hoping they have a picture of like. Oh no, they don't. Okay, never mind. Sleeping Bulbasaur plush does not have like the human to scale, but he is 16 inches of big plush. Big boy. He is big sleepy boy. He is best sleepy boy. Therefore, he is S tier. I'm surprised this time around we actually have some candidates for S tier because the transit, man, transit tier list. Everybody was a disappointment. Except that one meme one I put in S tier for German Taker Johnny. Just because I know he doesn't like it. S is for Dinah's being a sarcastic little shit. Charmander. I've noticed, I feel like Charmander gets better colors. Because I have my own Charmander plush a friend gave me. And like the color accuracy to this boy, aside from like him, I think the original Charmander was a little bit more dinosaur-y, and nowadays he's more like super horribly orange. I say horribly because I hate Funko Pops. Oh, look at this cute boy. He's so cute. Anyway, it's pretty color accurate. I don't know. This picture makes him look real derpy. He gets D for, oopsies. D for failed derp. All right, we got a lot of these to go through. I might have to start speedrunning because I promised my cat I would get off at some point and play with her. I recognize she does not understand human language, that won't stop me from telling her things. Gonna be honest, I feel like the longer I stare at this backpack Charmander, the more I fear that he's gonna smile, but then have like that toothy, bloody grin that you see on like creepypastas or something. I'm sorry, he's too creepy. This is the unfortunate. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan. This boy's not good. Hat Charmander. I don't know. I mean, like, having a lizard on your head isn't a bad thing. I actually really wanted a pet lizard for a while. But, like, literally everybody in my life hates, like, reptiles. Like, I wanted a snake as a pet for one point. I wouldn't mind some sort of lizard. But, like, I don't, like, my mom didn't like them. Like, my mom was like, if you ever have a snake in the house, I'm not coming in. So I never had a snake then. Then none of my current partner, I'm like, hey, what if I got a snake? And he's like, no. I'm like, okay. My friend had a king snake for years and he had to get rid of it after he got married. I'm sorry, he should have thrown away that whole marriage. The missus didn't want it. No, no. Snakey boy. Like, I don't need, like, a whole room of snakes. I just, like, want one little, like, one snake. Like a boa or something. He eventually did. Oh. He shouldn't have got rid of the snakes then. I'm just saying. Like, for myself, I'm like, okay. I went into this joint union knowing that I'll never get a reptile. But his missus, but not before getting rid of the snakes. Like, his missus knew he had a snake. He should have, I keep seeing these Reddit posts of, like, people that are like, oh, like, my so-and-so wanted to move in, but then, like, they're like, can you get rid of your cat? And you're like, no, we're a package deal. And then they dump the person, and the person's like, you're gonna regret dumping me for your cat. And it's like, no, this cat's been with me for, like, ever. I feel exactly the same way as other pets. Like, if I had, like, a snake and a lizard and my spouse wanted me to get rid of them, or, like, I think fiancé or whatever, like, whatever, a significant other wanted me to get rid of them, I'd be like, no. Absolutely not. Package deal, my friend. Package deal. Anyway, we were talking about Pokemon plushes. I don't know. This one looks kind of derpy. We're going to put it in D for derp. Charmander's not doing so hot right now. I will say I'm a little biased. This boy, if you've ever seen dinosaurs in, like, natural science museums, like dinosaur plushes, this is what it reminds me of. This is, like, some low-quality shit right here. Pokemon Center, I'm disappointed. I have, like, because, like, okay. So there's, like, a couple of ways to get Pokemon plushes. One is, like, Pokemon Center. Usually pretty good shit, good quality shit. Then there's, like, other companies, like the Charmander I have is a, like, different brand, but it's, like, pretty accurate. This guy just ain't it. I recognize that it's not Christmas yet, but apparently all the advertising I've been getting on Hulu says otherwise. I will say, this is very cute. I don't know why they decided to put Charmander in a reindeer outfit. I also think that whatever, I think this is supposed to be his tongue or something. Totally a bad move. They should have just stuck to the one mouth thing. But they tried. We're going to put it in for B, for but they tried. This boy, he's kind of chonky, but he has a cute little ribbon. I highly doubt he would stand on his own, though. So he's going to go for into C for can't stand. This boy, he's so sad. He's so sad. I don't know why he's sad. I feel like the quality of the fabric looks a little cheaper as well. I'm sorry, Charmander is not doing too hot in this. He's not doing too hot. The only one I like is this boy, because his round, he has no face. But he got a little pattern, and he has these little feet, and it kind of reminds me of a Care Bear. This is a good Care Bear. It's like a little baby toy, even though this thing was, I think it's like $35 or something, because it's made out of good fabric. So, he gets, I think this is an A tier. He's made out of good fabric, he's a dumb-looking face, what more could you want? All Charmander plushies belong in U tier. That's a hot take. I have a couple of friends that really like Charmander. My personal favorite is Cyndaquil. I think it's because Cyndaquil is my first starter, because I started in Heart Gold. I didn't even start in the original Gold, I know. I'm terrible. But I remember, I don't know how this this worked. But I remember, I think we were going to go on a long trip at some point. I don't remember to where. But I just remember I stayed up past my bedtime to write like a page and a half essay about wanting a DS Lite. And I just remember I don't know how I managed to get a page and a half, because I basically was like, DS is good for long trips. That's the only argument. I wonder if my parents still have it, because I want to cringe at it. One moment, please. Okay, there we go. Sorry, I had to take my drugs. Not even once. Okay. Where was I going with this? Yeah, I don't know how I managed to convince my parents to get me a DS. Maybe they just really like the effort, but they've never let me get anything with that kind of argument again. Anyway, I'm biased towards Cyndaquil, but look at this plushie boy. He looks soft. He has small little feet. So innocent, yet so deadly. I got my sister a Mudkip plushie for her birthday. That's adorable. Also, hello, Lecho Llama. How you doing? I think one of my old friends, his favorite was Mudkip. But yes, he is a soft boy. Cyndaquil gets an S tier for soft boy. look at this happy round boy. Look at this happy round boy. I like to think, I think this plush was like one of those 12-inch, 16-inch ones, but like I like to think, because I've blown him up, this is like a 5-foot Cyndaquil, like from feet to head, 5 feet. You can't dispute me on that. Cyndaquil was my starter, bonus points. Yes, he was my starter. I named my Cyndaquil Torch, which I recognize is also not very original. But he was my best boy. He was my first starter. He was my first level 100 Pokemon, and also my last 100 level 100 Pokemon. I haven't really been playing a lot of Pokemon, but I like to think he's a big boy, but also there's not a lot going for him. His snout is kind of turned up like a like one of those anime characters that goes like, "I'm superior than you." So he gets he gets B tier for I like to pretend he's big. That's all. This boy, he sits. He is layers got fucked. Where did he go? Hold on. There he is. Look at this boy. Look at this boy. He's soft. He has pointy nose. I feel like this is actually potentially one of the more accurate plushes, oddly enough. Okay, let's see if I can spell Cyndaquil. Oh, wait, never mind. Electrolama put it in the chat. I don't even have to type it correctly. Okay, so there's a little bit of a curve. I think this was... I want to say this was, like, based off of, like, a shrew or something. I know that's what the curve reminds me of. But, like, I don't know. It's pretty darn color accurate. Probably it really helps that Cyndaquil doesn't have, any eyes. I'm gonna put him in A tier for accurate. I think this one's cuter though. He's a cute boy. So yeah, that's all that. Well, yeah. So again, please bear in mind, like, notice how many plushes there are, and that is, I think, very indicative of how popular they are. So let's keep that in mind, folks. Cyndaquil sadly only had 3, but I love Cyndaquil. Actually. So you could see out of this generation, probably Chikorita was the most loved because it had one more. Actually, they just came out with the Sleepy Chikorita, but I think it's sold out. A lot of them got sold out. Anyway, Totodile. The more I look at this thing, the more I'm like, positively, this boy is accurate. He is good boy. I think he gets an A tier. I don't even like Totodile that much, but he gets A tier for being accurate. Look at that. He absolutely nothing going on behind those eyes. This has less personality. I like this one because there's more personality going on. This one is just like... It's just like Godzilla light. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know the classic Godzilla picture? It's like that, but subdued. Like, it's like... It's like the Geico Gecko decided to get an upgrade, but not too much of an upgrade. He gets a C. He did his homework. He's not going to fail, but he's not exactly winning. I know, these are some hot takes here. Now this... I believe this is in the series of their Poke Doll plushes. Like, so you know how in the games that you have the Poke Doll, but like it's usually like a Cleff... I think it's a Cleffa. But I guess there's other Poke Dolls and stuff you can see in the anime, but, like, I think this is what this is supposed to be. I don't know why they decided to give him absolutely no neck. Yes, one of these is not like the others. I don't know why they decided not to give him a neck. If anybody watches trash TV in some capacity like I do, if you happen to watch 90 Day Fiancé, my gut reaction is that he looks like Big Ed. I'm not sure if that's a compliment or an insult to this Totodile plush. I don't want to insult the real human though too much, but we'll just leave it at that. Frankly, okay. If someone handed this to me, if this was a metaphorical paper and this was handed to me, I'd say you should be expelled. You failed. You didn't read the homework assignment. So anyway, let's get to the more well loved plush, Chikorita. It's very cute. Fun fact, I discovered what bay leaf was when Ash's, it's Chikorita, bay leaf, and then Meganium. I discovered what bay leaf was when my mom happened to stop by and saw my brother and I watching Pokemans, and she's like, oh, bay leaf is an actual thing. And I'm like, what? And she took out some bay leaf and I sniffed it, and I'm like, wow, cool. But now that I'm older, I'm like, gosh dang, did you really not have any other names, any other creative names than stealing an herb name? So anyway, this is a passable. I think he's B tier. You did good. You didn't do spectacularly, but this is, you made your mother proud. I think I knew the Pokemon first too. Yeah, I will. Oh my gosh. I can't wait to indoctrinate my future hypothetical children into Pokemon. And I say this specifically because the Pokemon Center has like children's books to like learn colors and like numbers and like shapes and stuff. But more importantly, they literally have books that are just like, hey, let's talk about Pokemon types. This is a fire type. Cyndaquil is a fire type. And then Magmar is a fire type too. And you're like, well, gosh darn, this isn't even subtle anymore. They're just starting the indoctrination early. And I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. This is gonna be on my future hypothetical children's bookshelf along with, I swear I saw somewhere, it was like coding logic for children. And surprisingly, it was very helpful to understand some of it. So like, it was like an and statement or like an or statement. I think it explained with like pressing buttons or something to figure out how it works or whatever. Surprisingly educational. But yeah, I strive to have the weirdest shit in my future hypothetical children's bookcase. I will be the weird parent. I won't give them the weird names, I promise. I've thought about some weird names, but I've had some good thinks. It definitely helps that I name my cat Hobbs instead of naming a human Hobbs. Yeah, anyway. It's cute. I like the little, like, face. He sits. Probably good at sitting. That's a big plus. Some of these plushes just cannot sit. I think this is some A tier quality right here. This boy, I think this is very mellow. I like the colors. I know it's not color accurate, but I love the colors. And I believe it's under plushes. It should be new. It's fairly recent. Gib. Simon says, okay, you know what? You're not going to give me the latest one. So we're going to do new releases. And then we're gonna do plushes. Pins. Poke plushes. Don't look at these. Some of these I have thoughts on. They're very questionable plushes at times. Wait, okay. You know what? We're just gonna look up Chikorita. Chikorita plush. I think this boy sold out. Yeah, he's sold out. But like, look at this boy. I think it's partially cut. Yeah, it's partially cut off here. Wait. Nope. Absolutely head empty. I would use this as a pillow. 10 out of 10. I think this is S tier. S tier for sleepy boy. Best sleepy boy. In line, I would say, as great, if not greater, than Bulbasaur sleepy boy. And finally, I think this is also Pokédoll plush, but like, it's kind of cute. Like, this Totodile is derpy as hell. This boy, he has no legs at the back. Oh, woo, he is cute boy, needs to be protected. Little tiny, like, stubs, has a little woo. He's good boy, is A tier. Or actually, no, let's B tier. He doesn't have feet. You got most of the assignment, but not quite all of it, so you still pass. This one can't battle for shit. Look, it's the thought that counts. All right. Let's how many more pages? We can take a little bit of time. We can take a little bit of time. Trico, I will admit, Hoenn, not my favorite. I enjoyed having, I quite actually, so you know, as much fun as it is to see Ash battle, I like having, like, other aspects of Pokemon in the anime. So, like, having in Hoenn, they had Mei, and her doing, like, contests, I thought was, like, really innovative. Like, you know, like, Pokemon battles is just, like, use flamethrower, dodge it kind of thing. Whereas, like, contest was like, all right, you're going to use Bubble Beam, but you're going to turn it into, like, a whirlpool. Don't ask how it doesn't hurt anybody. Pokemon logic is stupid. It contradicts itself constantly. But, like, it was interesting. And I liked that. And I'm so sad they have never made, like, a Pokemon contest game. Like, the original Sinnoh Pokemon contest was, like, the closest thing I'm ever going to see to anything interesting. And that one wasn't particularly interesting, in my opinion. But this Treecko, he sits. I honestly, you could probably also go to, like, a zoo, like, gift shop. And you could get one similar to this. But, like, for a real lizard. This is the epitome of the meme. Hey, can I copy your homework? Sure, just don't make it. Just make it look different. You bet. And the copied assignment was the zoo gift shop gecko lizard. Anyway, this boy ain't cool. I think I distinctly really liked, or my brother really liked, that Treecko was, like, always being so cool and stuff and, like, so aloof and whatever, and then he turned to a whatever the second evolution is. Sceptile is the last evolution. Grovyle. Turned into a Grovyle, and it was so cool, and he had blades on his arms, and, like, there was actually some training going on. This is, like, when you have cool, awesome dad, and it's like, and here's my son, and he comes out, he's like, yeah, I'm gonna fuck you up, and then he has a stick, whereas the dad has a giant knife. This is the son. He's trying his hardest, but he ain't there. He's C tier four. He ain't there yet. he's trying. This boy, he gives me, like, Build-A-Bear vibes. And I don't like Build-A-Bear very much. They're not cute. I know they have, like, Pokemon Build-A-Bears now, and they're... If you could hear that, that's my cat crying. I think she's demanding attention, but I have a stream going on, and one of us supports the other, so... Anyway, Build-A-Bear. Does it look great? I know some of the Pokemon ones are... They have some Pokemon Build-A-Bears, and they're kind of cute, but, like, some of them, you're just like, ugh, why'd you do that to them? Ooh. Anyway, frankly, I feel like I should be able to, like he has wires in him and you can bend him to do things, but he doesn't. He probably doesn't stand by himself. He probably won't sit. Cat is big zoomies. If you hear weird growling in the background, it's her. Don't worry. She does this all the time. Anyway, this is D tier for, didn't read the homework assignment. I am very sorely disappointed in... Hobbs, what happened to being a silent killer? I can hear you doing all of those steps. I hope my mic didn't pick that up. This is embarrassing. My cat can't even be quiet, and she's supposed to be a silent killer. So disappointed. This boy, I think this is the closest we're going to get to a good-looking Treecko. Have I been calling this a Totodile? I don't remember. But, his portions probably aren't right. Treecko. Thank you, Google, for anticipating. Like, I think the problem is that, like, his legs are so thin. It's gonna be hard to get a good sit, like, a good standing boy. So they decided to go with tubes instead of, like, finesse. And then, like, he's supposed to have a bigger tail, but then it's so small, and this is not... Like, his tail should be the size of his head, if not more. And look at this. Look at this pathetic thing. I take my... he also... What, he has, like, the Mario nose. What's up with that? He goes into the D tier. He also didn't read the assignment. He's not as bad, though, as this one. I think this is also supposed to be a Pokédoll, but... It's not great. It's not great. We're just gonna put him for E for let's just exit this now. Okay. We're gonna go with this pathetic little thing. This isn't Chikorita. This is Torchic. I like that Torchic doesn't technically have arms, and then it gets arms, and then it turns into a giant hawk thing that's gonna like fly and kick-a-pow you. But I particularly grabbed this picture because I think it's really funny that they have the sizing of this boy. If you would like to take out your measuring tape right about now, you will recognize that this thing is small. So small, in fact, I bet you could put it into a t-shirt cannon and shoot it at somebody. Apparently t-shirt cannons are things that people like. So I imagine people wouldn't mind being like shot at with a Torchic plush this size. I think that's what they do. Anyway, this boy's great. I'm gonna crop it a little bit so it can fit better. We're gonna crop it a little bit just so it fits better onto the thing. I'm running out of space here, as you can see. Serviceable Torchic. I think assignment well matched. I like to think that this okay, I'm gonna have to crop this more. I like to think that this Torchic is a one-to-one a scale of actual Torchic. So just imagine this tiny little chicken, this fiery chicken, like you're just like, oh, how cute, I'm gonna go punt it across the lawn, and then it just like embers you and then lights your lawn on fire. Yeah. This boy is kind of derpy. It reminds me of two like satchel bags smooshed together. I don't think they read the homework. I don't think the ratio, the body ratio is right. We're gonna put you in C tier. Passable, not a great grade though. This boy, yeah, he's not bad. Yeah, you know, I think he's A tier. I don't like Torchic, but I think this is a good looking one. It's not too bad. This boy, speaking of one of these is not like the other, like this is not color accurate in any sense. Give me Torchic. Like is orange. Like what is this weird orange? Like this is, see this? You can't really see, but like see this boy, and you tell me this is the same thing? Absolutely not. This is like your discount Phoenix. We're putting, no, a D for discount. Absolutely not. No, I disagree with the colors. And lastly is just this boy. He kind of reminds me of like a, the top of a tiki. I don't know how else to explain it. Like the boop. Psh. Anyway, C tier. You know, it's probably the same thing as this one. Again, they had different sizes, and I think I added some of the other sizes, not really the others. I don't know. All right. I gotta shrink down some of these. Oopsie daisies. I gotta hold on. Step one, lock that. Step two, select all of these. Oh, whoopsies. I locked the wrong thing. One second. Let's just. Okay, now I lock that. And now we're free to do what we want. Look at these boys. I'm going to shrink them down so we have more space for the last few. I'm not going to bother shrinking the S tier because there are some that are pretty great, but I'm not sure if it's like worth making the space, you know? There's not a lot of S tiers going on here. Also, if anyone's wondering, the music in the background is just like some jazz Halloween music I found like a couple of years back, and I'm just like, yeah, I'm kind of tired. I imagine everyone else is kind of tired. So we're just gonna listen to this while I rant about Pokemon plushes. Speaking of ranting about Pokemon plushes, look at this boy. He has a lot of thoughts going on. You can tell from his eyes, the distant look. It's not quite thinking about the horrors of war, but it's not quite head empty. He might just be thinking about his breakfast. Or he's thinking about that math problem that someone told him about. Either way, he's a big thinky boy. I think he's good. He's gonna go in A tier. He's a good thinky boy. He somehow gets A's even though he barely studies. This big sleepy boy, I wouldn't say he's... Actually, he might be pretty color accurate. This is Mudkip. Look at that face. I think he's pretty darn color accurate. Magboy, he's very sleepy. I would hold. The face is great. I think he deserves the S for sleepy tier. Noticing a trend here. I think, you know, I promise I'm not paid by Pokemon or Game Freak or anything. But I think right now I am giving them some good quality data for free. That being said, if they want to pay me, I really want to get a hold of that Van Gogh Pikachu if possible. I think it's sold out forever, but I really wanted a Pikachu with a little hat and paint set. I heard you like Mudkips. I do not like Mudkips. I just think Mudkip's voice is very cute in the anime. I like to, you know, I don't really think about it, but like someone had to voice all those Pokemon. So like someone was like in the studio going like Mudkip, Mudkip, Mudkip. And like for every single fucking episode that stupid thing was in. And then they got paid for it, man. You know, some people are like, yeah, I want to get into like voice acting and stuff for like so I can be an anime, but like, you know, we all need like the little guys. Like someone has to be Mudkip, you know? Like you don't have to be Meowth. You can be Mudkip and you can still make a living. Anyway, so if they're looking for voice talent for Pokemon, I apparently am great at this. I work for food sometimes, depending on where you're taxing me. I also work for Boba. Anyway, so with that out of the way, I'm gonna be honest, I don't like the eyes on this one. I think the body's pretty great. I like the little feet, the little puppy feet. He's a very good sticky head up fin thing and great fins, but like those eyes, it's not doing it for me. I think there's something about those eyes that are kind of soulless. I was just finishing a disenchantment with a spouse, and they have in disenchantment these things called trogs, and they're like weird gray wrinkly looking things, and they're kind of gross, and like their eyes kind of look like this, and I do not like. Anyway, so I mean the assignment was done pretty good. You still pass, but I disagree with your argument. This boy, he sits. I like the little stitching on his little fins. I think the other ones had it, but especially it's kind of nice. I get the weird feeling it's not gonna sit well. It looks a little overstuffed. Generally, I think this is a passable plush. I think this is a B tier. It's not quite good, but I have no... it's just personal qualms at this point. Let's see. This boy is also good. His head is probably too big, so he's not gonna stand. I would not like him, but I'm sure some small child would. So this goes into, I think this is B tier. I'm sorry. I just, this first one, he had so much, this one had so much personality. This one is head empty, absolutely empty. Okay. So where's that? So yeah. You can kind of tell who was the fan favorite. Out of, like, Sinnoh region Pokemans? Can you tell? Because I couldn't tell. Let's just start with the poor little Turtwig. If I'm being honest, that's one derpy looking Turtwig. His eyes, like, he's a little cross-eyed, I think. I think he would sit well. I think this is one of their sitting, they have a sitting cuties line, and I disagree with them generally, because it's just basically they took the Pokédex for that region and then made it into plushes, and like, I don't think every Pokemon is made to be a plush. There's some cute ones, surprisingly, like the Gears from Unova. I can't remember the name of it, but surprisingly cute as a plush. And they're also kind of expensive for the price, for the size, and I'm like, eh, I don't think they're worth it. It is color accurate. He's a little cross-eyed. I think if they... there could be some improvements. So I think C tier is appropriate. It's passable, but like not quite right. It's not quite right. I'm gonna have to make room in C tier. All right, this boy, I think he's less color accurate, but he sits. He's a little stupid eyed. Yes, just because we're making fun of a plush, yes. I think this one is definitely less color accurate. Turtwig. Turtwig, I think, was my best friend's first starter. Did I post it in the Discord? I at one point... Oh, man, hold on. I think my playlist ran out. What are we listening to now? Oh, never mind. Hold on. This is Toho. We are not listening to Toho right now. We're gonna... No, stop it. I'm not listening to Toho right now. We're gonna... I can't listen to... If we do Animal Crossing, this is gonna get demonetized. We're gonna go back to swinging. No, yes. No, yes. We're gonna go... My favorite playlist... I got distracted. I was doing something. I don't know what possessed me, but when I first got my, when I first got my drawing program, I think I Procreate. This is such a long, long, stupid explanation. So there was a brand that was making Pokemon like button-ups and stuff, and like it was custom made and everything, and like I was like thinking about the time of like stuff to get my best friend who is like non-binary, so like traditionally feminine or masculine clothes sometimes doesn't work, so I was just kind of looking into other stuff and alternatives. So I basically drew them as like a Pokemon trainer and had a little Turtwig in their hands. And it was very cute. And he was very derpy. I don't know if I ever posted that picture because it's kind of like a... It's kind of like a nice little thing. Also, there's an ad break going on Twitch, so I will take this time to thank my 4 subscribers. You helped me slowly bring me towards being able to... cash out and get myself boba. Although I really should be just putting the money back into stream or something, I don't know. And thank you to my 61 followers. 61's a great number, and we're only 8 away from making me laugh a little bit because I'm a child. Yes, Turtwig. Turtwig, great. He's not... Yeah, this one isn't particularly color accurate. But I think he has like that soft, like baby doll, like not like baby doll as in like, I don't know, weird things, but like kid, like a baby's toy kind of like soft color kind of thing, you know? And I quite like that. I think, I think I would hope that this is a big boy, but I think it's a small boy. But he sits, he fits, he sits in my heart. He's a good boy. He's a good boy. I quite liked Ash's Charmander's like arc in the anime. And I quite like Chimchar because of that. But like, these look like discount Sun Wukong, like the Monkey King. Like this isn't Charmander. This is just like, no, this isn't even like discount Sun Wukong. This is like discount Sun Wukong's like child. Like this ain't like the stitching like right there under his eyes makes him look not that great. Like. Let's go look up poor real Charmander. Like, Char. I mean, it's not even the first thing that comes up. Wait, this isn't a Charmander. This is a. Why am I blanking? Was I just calling him a Charmander? Uh-oh. It does start with a CH, right? It's not Charizard. So it turns into Infernape. I'm just gonna look up Infernape. And then, oh, it's a Chimchar. maybe that's also something that translation team at Game Freak needs to consider. Don't make your Pokemon sound alike. It's gonna confuse little old me. But yeah, look at this boy. Look how cute he is. You know, he has like these little swirls going around. I think generally speaking, this is like a good, there's definitely a lot of inspiration from like the Sun Wukong stuff. I think like his little swoosh kind of looks like fire. His very round designs. I think generally it's a good Pokemon design. And then you look at this. And then you look at that. And then you look at this. Like they're all disappointments. There's not a good one amongst them. None of these are good. Maybe this one, because he's kind of soft looking, but like this one looks so 2D. This one also looks 2D. They're all E tier, I'm sorry. Like Chimchar needs to be held back a grade. I don't want to put him in F tier because that's mean. And I also don't have an F tier, but they're so bad. Like, the homework assignment was failed 3 times over. It's so bad. Pokemon Center, you failed Chimchar. Give us good Chimchar. Chimchar deserved better. All right, okay, let's go to the darling child, and then we'll wrap up this evening. Let's start with the ones that are actually Piplup shaped, and then we'll talk about the ones that are round. This boy is kind of fluffy, very round, very plush. I think I've had this plush with this kind of fabric, and it's very nice. So this one gets S tier for silky smooth. I don't know if that's actually true. I do not have one of those. This boy will not sit, probably, will probably fall over. I think this is also one of the sitting cuties. I could be wrong. It's passable. I don't think it's particularly cute. It gets a B tier. It's not bad looking. I think they had I'm imagining they had like an easy time for whatever reason getting like Piplup to look right. But like, cause like, I think a lot of the plushes are pretty color accurate, but like, I don't know. They really dropped the ball on some of these plushes. This boy is pretty cute looking. Maybe this one is a sitting cutie. I also feel the urge to throw this at someone's face. Just like ball it up in your hand and just go yeet. Just yeet him. Would make a good reusable snowball, in other words. I think this is A tier. They knew what they were doing. I assume they have sold lots. The reviews are probably, well, actually, most reviews on Pokemon Center, like, no, like 99% of reviews on Pokemon Center are good. The only time I see complaints is like, oh, I didn't get it, or like, even like the derpy ones, they're like, oh, he's a little crooked, but I still love him anyway. It's like, Pokemon Center knows exactly what they're doing. Okay, so these ones, I wasn't sure if I wanted to count because there was like, especially this one, there was like a Mantyke. So we're gonna ignore the little, this, we're gonna pretend the Mantyke is just a cushion. This one, yeah, I think you can still buy this one, by the way, if you're wanting a Piplup for Halloween. Cute overall. I think it has a lot of personality. Not very huggable because it has this donut thing, and I would imagine these applique things are kind of like stiff felt. The hat is very cute. It's like a little pumpkin. I think it gets B tier. It's not quite cute enough, I think, and not quite huggable enough to go any further. But points for original design and concept. This boy's head is empty. It's not even like cute head empty. This is just absolutely soulless. Like, this Mantyke has more personality. This tiny little last Pikachu thing here has more personality. The hat's cute. Overall, not a bad execution. I kind of wish it's not a great plush. It's not a great plush. I get plushes to hold and to soothe the fact that inside I'm just constantly screaming because I don't know what to do. This does not soothe me. All right, let's get to these boys that are flat. I think these are quite big. I think they're like 18 inches each. They look big because I blew them up. Let's see. I think this is like cheaper fabric, and this one is higher quality fabric. Either way, I like the blue on the eyes better on this one. It's quite cute. This one, less so. I like the softness, even though this isn't color accurate. The softness of the colors is very nice. Would put on my Kardash. This deserves an A tier. Right after I make space an A tier. A tier. He's part of the A team. This boy, he's passable. He gets B tier. He did the assignment, but he didn't have that special oomph to give you like the extra, you know. There we go. All right, let's get to the round boys, and then we'll talk about this boy. So I believe there is two Squishmallows of Piplups, because once again, we know who the golden child is of the starters. So I think this is like, I think this is a 16 inch and this one is a 32. So technically this is one plush. We're going to consider this one plush. But bonus points for the fact that they have, actually, I think they might have three different sizes. Of this plush, but bonus points to the fact that they have like multiple sizes of this one plush. I will say I do not like it when I think Squishmallows have gotten a little overblown. Like the simple designs, like I have, what is his name? I have the dinosaur that came out, like it's one of the original designs. I don't remember his original tag name, but his name is Mochi because he was soft like Mochi when I first got him, and he was fantastic. Now he's a little deflated, but you just kind of throw him into the wash and let him go womp, 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 and then he's all fluffy again. This actually might also be a Squishmallow. I don't like that the Squishmallow shape makes him kind of more, or Piplup more like an egg shape. It's kind of a shame. The eye color, though, I think is a lot better. I think it would have been cuter instead of doing, like, three ovals to like make the do like the little anime thing where it's just like boop boop boop. I like the little flipper. I like how this bit isn't just sewn on, it's like an extra bit of fabric. I think this would make a little child very happy. I think they read the assignment and they did well. This is A tier. I'm just gonna put it small because I don't want to mishear it. Okay. So this boy. Usually I'm like, ignore the fact that I've blown this up and the sizing looks weird, but like, I chose this particular picture because you notice, like, this Piplup is absolutely huge. Like, if we're doing plush. Where is it? Where's the boy? Where's the boy? Is it this one? Yes, it's this one. This one is, it's 31 inches. It's, oh, they have a big gnome? Anyway, this is like that meme where it's like me, my girlfriend, and her $500 4 foot life-size Mareep. Like, if you have a twin bed, this thing ain't fitting with you. It's either you or the Piplup. If you have like a full or like a queen, and you share it with a partner, like the partner's getting kicked out. Like, it's just you and the Piplup. This thing is absolutely massive. I don't know how many people bought it. It's huge and I love it. I'm an adult and my arms reach all the way around its head, but reach all around its head, but I'm so in love. Only trouble is I had to kick my husband off the bed. See, what am I tell you? You know, you get this Piplup, you lose your partner. Well, let's see. Absolutely fucking ginormous. Truly. Truly, this 31-inch, like, 31 inches does not seem like a lot, but look at this thing. Look at this thing. Absolutely ginormous. It's almost the size of this waifu pillow. Like, this is your child. He is big child. Definitely worth the price. Very big and friend-shaped, yes. Yes. And then he fits in beanbag chair, so now he watches over the living room with godlike aura. Yes. Anyway, point being, big boy. I wouldn't say he's best boy because Piplup is not my favorite. But he is the king. I think Big Piplup is the king of S tier for now. Anyway, so there's like, I think, five other regions. Let's see, this other one. Hold on, let me think on this one. 2, 3, 4. Yeah, there's like five other regions. I think we're up to 8, 9 regions right now. Clearly, they're not going to fit on the same tier list, so I'm going to have to shrink everything down to fit it all. But yeah, I realize I'm like, I can't keep scrolling back and forth and back and forth. This is absolutely ridiculous. This is getting a ginormous, but yeah, this is Kanto, Johto, Hoenn, Sinnoh. Wait, Kanto, Johto, Hoenn, Sinnoh. Yeah, okay, that's the four regions. And then I think next is Unova? Yeah, next is Unova. And then I lose count of what the names are. I hope I didn't ruffle. Actually, I do hope I ruffled some feathers. That's the point of tier lists. We're here to anger the people. Truly, this is the point of being on the internet, to ruffle some feathers. So with that, I think it's time to start wrapping up here. I guess this was some brief life updates. I do apologize to people who like to tune in, but I have this I've been quite tired. I know I complain about that a lot, but I'm currently being tested for I will be tested at some point for some sleep disorder issues. So at least I have an excuse as to why I'm always tired. But yes, it's been life has been weird on this end. But I'm trying my hardest for the viewers, especially with this tier list. I'm still trying to find out like what stuff, because like sometimes I'm just like, but I don't want to stream because I don't want to play this game. So that's why I did a tier list, because these things are stupid and they're fun. And also it's just like, yeah, you know, what are we doing here? I just want to do things. Actually, I think something that's been super something I want to do more is collabs. It's really hard for with my schedule, but I really want to do more collabs. I had a lot of fun with Noodle and Fruitsy with the forest. And I hope everyone else enjoyed the collab. Noodle and I have been talking about other collabs and stuff as well, and I've been talking to other people, and yeah, we'll see. It might be one of those weekend things, but weekends also get kind of weird. I'm gonna go see Spirited Away this weekend, speaking of which. A Japanese sub. I've never seen Spirited Away. Actually, I don't see a lot of Ghibli movies with this sub. I don't know why. I watch them all in dub. But yeah. Yeah, that's just a little bit of a life update. I know there's like a week, in a couple of weeks, I won't be able to stream because work, but then we'll get to that bridge. But yeah, we're just gonna, you know, casually wind this down for everybody. I do enjoy some of these more chill streams in the evenings. I think I wanna gear more towards chill streams, so like no league during the week. We're gonna do some chill things like tier lists, dumb tier lists, or like maybe some chill Animal Crossing while we just chat about life. Yeah, I mean, like, if there's, I know Starman, you've put lots of suggestions in the games, but if there's things y'all want to do, I'm open to them. Throw them in the Discord. We can have a chat. It'll be great. But yeah, let's wind this down here. Yeah. All right, there's no one I want to raid tonight. I'm also kind of tired. I've used the last bit of my energy to do this stream. But yeah, let's, I think this is it for tonight. I will probably be able to stream sometime next week, and we can finish up this, tier list, and we can, what else can we do? We can play some games. We'll play some chill games. Maybe I'll actually finally finish Cat Cafe Manager. Who knows? I don't actually even know if there's an end to that game. I considered playing, I have a Control, because I really like the aesthetic, but I get scared. But, like, it's spoopy season, and I kind of want to do something spoopy. So, potentially, I'll try to play that on stream as long as my computer decides not to shit itself. But yeah, we'll see what the vibe is. But yeah, I hope everyone has a good night. German Taker Johnny, especially, I hope life perks up for you, my dude. As always, Starman, thank you for joining and having silly things to say. And Lutra Llama, I hope you're well. And to the rest of my viewers and followers, I hope you're gonna do okay during this spooky season. Especially those of you who are scared of the decorations like I am. Like, who the fuck needs a giant ass spider as a fucking decoration? Anyway. Thank you all for tuning in. It's always a pleasure sharing an evening, a few hours in the evening with y'all. I hope y'all will do well. I hope y'all are hydrated. Stay safe. And be kind to others. And we will see y'all next time. Good night.